First to basically the building blocks, the fundamental building blocks in programming, which can explain the machine language. The object code is basically electrical impulses. It's ones and zeros, the binary language. So anything which a human can interpret stops at the source code level as the basic fundamental element. After that, the rest is all electrical impulses, which translates the machine into action. So if you take the wisdom again, apply the same concept in human, any form of knowledge goes to a point where, before it gets converted into wisdom, it reaches a point, after that the rest is all bloodstream, muscle memory, and they say. Whether it's in sports, whether it's in any action, when you're actually doing something, after practice, learning and so on, it gets to a point, it gets into your bloodstream. After that, it's not the knowledge with you, it's become part of your system. Same way, in any scriptures and so on, it can only take you to a building blocks. After that, it helps you to actually understand the wisdom and digest. Are the four steps in the Sulanga. Sravanam, Mananam, Dhyanam, Nithi Dhyanam. Illati, are the same thing, they say, Aridal, Ninaital, Nadattal, Sindhital, Nadattal. Aridal under the knowledge. Knowledge needs to get converted into Mananam. Pendi Dhyanam Avarum, other Pendan and Nekonam. Pendi gets into your system, Nithi Dhyanam, Nadattal. Same way, Thirumandram to me, it's actually as one of the key scriptures which will help you to get to a point where once you break through, once you really understand it, it actually translates, the rest is becomes basic. So source code of Saiva Siddhantam, so Saiva Siddhantam principles are explained in a structured manner in Thirumandram. I'll pause there for a second and explain what is Thirumandram. Everyone probably knows about Thirumandram. But it's for various reasons, it has been actually been held back for a long, long time. Now, this scripture goes back way more than 2,000 years old. And it's revered as one of the 12 scriptures, revered scriptures in our Thirumurai, in Saiva tradition. Now, it's written by a Siddha saint, Thirumular, who is also one of the 63 Nayan men. Now, if you take Thirumandram per se, there are more than 3,000 lines, all coupled into, grouped into 9 Tandrangal. And each of the 9 Tandram has specific subjects taking a human in his advancement to spirituality. So, Mudalam Tandratla is the Umbadam Tandram Varekam. Sometimes people also, scholars have interpreted this as the 9 key Agamas as well in our tradition. So, Muayram lines are basically, 3000 stanzas, 12000 lines, 200000 words, it basically contains everything you need to know about Saiva Siddhantam. Now, if I take Saiva Siddhantam per se, it starts with, Thirumandiram starts with, sums up in 4 lines, the core of the triad of Padipasupasam. So, Padipasupasam ena paharur moondril, Padi inai pol pasupasam anadi, Padiyai chendranaha pasubhasam, padiyanahi pasubhasam nillame. It's 115 stanza in the first tandra. Basically, it sums up in a nutshell, in a beautiful sense, in a scholarly sense, as well as, like I said, it's a basically fundamental building block which goes right into the heart of Saiva Siddhantam principle. Also, the word of Saiva Siddhantam appears for the first time in all the Thirumurai, for the first time in Thirumandram. Now, if I just go into the key principles of Saiva Siddhantam, all the key aspects are grouped. Uraiyal, Padi, Pasiriyal, or Uyiriyal, then Thalaiyal, which is your bondage, and then the Sadhanaiyal and Payaniyal. These are the 5 key groupings which is structured in Sivajnana Bodham, which is also one of the 14 Mahayana Shastras, in a very structured scientific manner explaining the whole of Saiva Siddhantam principle, tradition. Thirumandiram also takes a view, sometimes people, actually there's a fellow presenter who is going to be talking about the scientific aspects. Is this a science? Is this a spirituality? Is this talking about physics? Is this talking about universe? Trimandiram is basically layer beneath layer. It's one scripture which talks about a vast plethora of topics. So if I go back to the Sarvasiddhanta principle, how it's explained, the omnipresence, omniscience, omnipotence of Shiva, is Lord Shiva, is clearly explained through a number of stanzas in Trimandiram, especially in Tandiram 2. Then it goes into basically the Anavam Kanvam Maya, the Malangal, and then Sahalar Vinyanakalar Pradayakalar definition of different souls, different individual beings, are clearly explained again in Trimandiram through number of stanzas in a scientific sense, not in a just a theological. Incidentally, Trimandiram is the only one in the 12 Tirumurai which is both a hymn as well as a sastra. So sastramum thotramum ore puttama irukkirathu ore scripture irukkirathu Trimandiratla mattumdan thalaiyil eduthamna naanga basically adula irukkira 36 tattvangalum in a, once again karuvutpatti and karuvutpattikku mudhalla irundhu Shivan appadi the creation creative aspects of it, fundamental building blocks of our evolutes, Shiva Tattvam Anjam, Sakti Tattvam Uppataram, and the Sakti Tattvam Uppataram, again it breaks down into Vidya Tattvam, Atma Tattvam, early Vidya Tattvam, Micham, Irvathor Atma Tattvam, and Adukkula it goes further into the fundamental aspects of every aspect, Prakriti Tattvam, and the Prakriti Tattvam 20, Adukkula Andha Karanangal, Pendu Panjabhudangal, Ellam, it goes into a very, very structured analysis. Then the fourth aspect, sadhanaya. If you take sariya kriya yogam jnanam, the fundamental paths of spirituality, as explained through Sarvasiddhanta tradition, is once again explained in a step-by-step, category-by-category in Trimandiram. There is also the four margas, depending on the consciousness of individual devotees. So you have the sanmargam, sahamargam, satputramargam, dasamargam. Each of the aspects, based on the state of consciousness, based on your state of being, is taken through, step by step, through Trimandiram. Then the Sakti Nivada, which is basically the God's grace, descent of grace. That's the last section, pioneer. Once again, that also is elaborated through Trimandiram. So now we step back and ask ourselves, we do have a source code here. Not to say that the other scriptures don't come into this in making it whole, but Trimandiram as a standalone scripture runs through everything one needs to know, not just about Sarvasiddhantam, but everything about spirituality. Interestingly, I would like to sum it up actually with a comment somebody mentioned 2 days ago. One of our elderly person woke up to me and said, it's interesting to see that you have done your postgraduate studies in Trimandiram per se, research, well done and all these things. Trimandiram is an encyclopedia, isn't it, of spirituality. My view is it's actually, it's more than encyclopedia. To me, encyclopedia is a reference manual. So a reference manual in spirituality is more of a static scalar. In a physics sense, it's a static document. That's what an encyclopedia is, a refer back. Whereas to me, Trimandiram is a vector. It's basically, it has the mass and it has a direction as well. It goes into extreme specific, I'm sure my friend will talk about, when he talks about yoga, he'll talk how much detail it goes compared to Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. In Patanjali's Yoga Sutras, you have only 126 lines, stanzas, on Ashtanga Yoga. Whereas in Trimandiram, just in one volume, just in one aspect of yoga, this is Ashtanga Yoga only, it talks through 335 stanzas. And it doesn't stop with Ashtanga Yoga. It goes beyond that, goes into various aspects, Chandra Yoga, Prasada Yoga, and so on. So I will let him talk through that, but these are the aspects which are going through. So it again prompts you to see, hang on, this is a dynamic scripture here. And even in yoga, just to highlight this point, I'll actually emphasize this. It goes into how many counts each breath should be in order to have your longevity. Sometimes it's mind-boggling. It's mind-boggling to see how thousands of years ago somebody when there was no medicine, when there was no concept of whatever we have been, you know, taking things for granted now, were not there. How these sages were able to actually go down to such a specific detail. The fetus formation in 10 months, what is the space shape it takes, what's the dimension it takes, every single detail is spelled out in a very, very scientific manner. We heard about Vastu Purusha, the eight directions. Tiruvandra goes beyond that. I'm sure learned people here will know that it's basically, it talks about Sulavaram, it talks about, but it goes way beyond what normally we could even understand or comprehend in our normal. But what does it mean now? So to me, actually, why did I do a research and what am I trying to do beyond this? Is that here is a scripture which goes way beyond what I know, what my fellow beings know at this stage. And it's part of our tradition. It's our obligation to somehow take this forward. Not just within our community. We have to go beyond our community. We got to take it in English, in Tamil. Beyond just translation, it has to go beyond interpretation. It has to find its way, and that's the thing which we all can do, to this great scripture. With that, I might actually conclude my presentation, and I'm happy to ask and answer any quick questions,
there
are any.
Yeah.
Sarvashastra Periyapuranam is the authentic and the most authoritative scripture talking about all the Nayanmar's life. So likewise, Tirumoolar's life in 28 stanzas is clearly explained by Sarvashastra, and that is the source. One other line it talks about, and even in Tirumandiram itself, Tirumoolar talks about his life. 3,000 years he came out of meditation, for every year he basically wrote the stanza, one stanza each. Now this puts us in a bit of a dilemma. How do we interpret this? Can somebody live for 3,000 years, number one? Then we are saying it's more than 2,000 years old scripture. What does it mean, all this? I'm happy to take this offline, but my little summation at this stage, and there's an elaborate answer to this. Firstly, though I also partly read about quantum science and physics and so on, relativity. If you take relativity, there is all sorts of theories which we don't know, which we can't comprehend, are coming into being. For example, they talk about black holes. A person can actually go, at when you are getting closer to the speed of light, your life reduces, whereas the earthly being's life remains at it. So if I suddenly get into a space shuttle and go closer to the light speed and come back, I'll see everyone here probably, and I'll remain what I am now in a second. Now, if I interpret the same way, Siddhas are supposed to be extremely evolved beings. The basics of whatever they have said, we are beginning to understand in some aspects. Like fellow presenter Alan Croker explained, some of these things about Chidambaram, I'm sure we have been going every year and coming back and so on. Suddenly you step back. Anu, Paramanu. Paramanu in the space, shape is cuboid. It's not circle, it's not sphere. A cuboid, when you rotate it fast, it becomes a sphere. That Chidambarathil explained panni irukku. Creation, utpatti kandathila ponavanda, how a cube converts itself into a sphere. Now, atom, as we understand in modern physics, has only sphere, it's spherical. But now latest research papers are coming through, although it's only research papers, it's not proven, that, hang on, when the sphere becomes stable, localized, it takes a cuboid structure. So same way, to be able to answer your question, this 3,000 year life of the Siddha, number one, and then how long the scripture has been there. Scholars have tried to use some words and interpret to see, okay, in this period it could have been there, because they the same similar languages are used. For example, Anju Mandalam and Solinam. And the Anju Mandalam, some scholars basically interpret as, okay, there was a time when Tamil Nadu was divided into Anju Mandalam, Thondai Mandalam, Solaman. But that is not that's a very direct translation. Anju Mandalam and Ponavanda, Angala Koshangalukum, interpretation. Sitharinda language is very hard to understand. So and the paribhashi adha vilangi vilangi layer beneath layer vilangi konde poheka, suddenly the things which we normally interpret as our time being loses its meaning in some aspects. But we don't need to get into all these details in order to be able to understand the scripture. To me, honestly, whether he lived 3,000 years ago or 23,000 years ago is not the topic here. The topic for me to actually take away is, here is a scripture in my tradition, wealth of all these, which I haven't found in my life. I'm 44 years old. I haven't seen any scripture. I've started reading about not just our religion, but also Islam and Christianity and so on. I haven't seen any scripture which goes into this level of detail in scientific sense. I'm yet to be proven I'm wrong, and I hope somebody can prove me wrong, but this is a fantastic scripture and it has so much details.